Hey, welcome back to the channel. So in this video, I'm going to talk to you about all the things that I take out on a short mountain bike ride. So that's one of my typical rides really, which is 2 hours, an hour and a half, something like that. So it's just in the middle of the work day, or it might be at the end of the work day, where I'm just getting out for a quick spin. So I won't go into detail on what I take on those longer 4 to 8 hour epic rides, but today is just for those short rides. I'll tell you everything I take out with me, food, tools, everything that I take. So before I get into the video, make sure you subscribe and enjoy it. So normally, if I'm just going out for an hour and a half to 2 hours, most of the nutrition that I need for that ride, I'll have already eaten pre-ride, so I'll have a really good meal. If I'm going out at 4 p.m. in the evening, I'll have been eating good all day, and then about half an hour to an hour before I actually start on the ride, I'll make sure I have something decent to eat, so I'm fueled up and ready for the ride. However, I always take some food with me just in case I get to that hour mark and I'm starting to flag or I'm starting to get hungry. But I don't take anything major. So when I do go on a short ride, I don't take a bag anymore. I put everything in my pockets or straps onto the bike. So nutrition needs to fit right into my pocket. So I keep it really simple. And again, this is just for rides under a couple of hours. So I'll always take some kind of flapjack with me. So these were just on offer in the supermarket. They're not like my favorite brand or anything. Just berry protein flapjack, Graze protein flapjack, so that fits nicely into my pockets, so nice and thin. And then I'll also take a couple of bags of sweets as well. So I've just got a massive sweet drawer, I've got loads of stuff in it, and I'll just grab a handful of something. So I've got a couple of bags of Haribo there. So I won't necessarily eat all of that or even any of that on a short ride, but at least I've got it in my pocket, and then if I absolutely need it, I can have it. If I was to get hungry on the trail, I would always have the flapjack first, probably about 40 minutes into the ride if I felt like I needed it, because that's lower GI carbohydrate. So what that'll do is it'll release the sugar more steadily and keep me fuller for longer. And then if I absolutely need it and I'm getting towards the end of the ride, maybe I've got 45 minutes left, I might have a bag of sweets at the hour mark, and then an hour and 20 minutes, an hour and 30 in, I might have another bag of sweets. But like I say, the sweets that I've got really in the flapjack is just in case I need it. On rides under 2 hours, I don't really need to eat a lot of the time. And then I also have my Fidlock water bottle as well. So this just clips onto my bike. I think from memory, there's 700 milliliters in this bottle. 600 milliliters, so this is a 600 milliliter bottle. So if it's a really sunny day, and like it's been recently, it's been boiling, then I will either take my rucksack, or halfway around my ride, I'll try and plan it so that there's an ice cream van or there's a Co-op or something like that, and then I can pop in and either refill my water or just buy a different drink. And when it's sunny, you need to be drinking 500 milliliters to a litre of water per hour. So 600 milliliters for a couple of hours in the boiling hot sun just doesn't cut it. But for a ride like today where the weather is grotty, that'll be more enough to keep me going. So that just straps onto the bike, and that's plenty for an hour and a half-ish for my kind of riding. So that's the nutrition covered. Then obviously I also have my trusty phone with me as well. So this goes on every single ride with me, and I always make sure there's more charge than I need. So I'll try and charge it for about an hour before I head out, so it's fully charged. I use Strava to record every ride, and I just do that on my phone. And I've got the iPhone XS Max, I think it is. So the battery life of it is really good. So I can use Strava in the background, and I can use Google Maps when I'm out and about. I can use my Instagram stories, and it'll last pretty much all day. I can go on 7 or 8 hour rides, and it will keep charged the whole time. In fact, I had this phone when I did the 24 hour ride last year, and I think I only needed to give it one full charge. I had a power pack with me, and the phone was about to die after about 12 hours, and I just plugged it into one power pack, and that kept it going for a full another 12 hours, so that lasts plenty for a ride. But that's essential, and you need that just to make sure that if you get into difficulty, you can call someone for help. I use it to record Strava. And if you're going out on your own as well, you can use Strava Beacon. So if you just set up some contacts within the Strava app, if you've got the paid version, it will text whoever you need it to text a beacon, which will show them where you are. So if for any reason you said you're going to be home for 5 p.m. and you're not, they can log on to Strava and see where you are and come and save you from being stuck in a ditch. But it's essential that always need to take your phone with you, and it always needs to be charged. So you've got the nutrition, we've got my phone and my methods of contact. And then after that, we need some kind of tools to make sure that I can get out on my ride and get back. So I actually split my tools in half. So I always have these three things, which I just have in a sandwich bag in my pocket. One thing I should say though, so I've got a multi-tool first of all, a couple of tire levers and some plugs. I'll go into more detail. This multi-tool is hard. I had a crash the other day on the bike and it imprinted into my leg. I ended up with a massive bruise on my thigh. I was limping around for a couple of days. So you could argue that it protected my leg, but to be honest, I think it was just something hard that I landed on. So what I probably would say is if you are going to carry something hard like a multi-tool in your pocket, you might want to get some kind of like little padded bag or something like that. But that's just a little heads up. So I've got my Crank Brothers multi-tool. So this has got pretty much all the things that I need. It's got a chain tool on there. It's got all the different Allen keys and different bits and bats that I need. So that can do everything from adjusting my seat post, changing my, taking my wheel off. Obviously you've got a chain tool to sort that out if you need to. So that's on there. I've got a couple of tire levers. So if I do need to get my tire off on the trail, I've got those in there to help. And they're just the really small ones. So they fit nicely in my pocket. In the garage, I've got some bigger ones, some stronger ones that I use if I'm doing it at home. But they're just nice ones to have out and about because trying to get your fingers into carbon rims just doesn't work, especially with that cush core in it now. One thing I've just realised I don't have here, I've also got a chain link as well, a quick link. So that's in there in case I snap my chain and I can use the chain tool to sort that out. And then I've also got a couple of tire plugs as well, or more than enough, 8 tire plugs. So you can see, I'll put it over the screen now. Also on my bike, I carry with me an inner tube and a CO2 canister with two CO2 canisters and the adapter to use it. So if I do have any issues, I've got a couple of attempts to fix it. So first of all, I can try plugging it if I get a puncture, and then I would use one of those CO2 canisters to reinflate the tire. If that doesn't work, I'll take the tire off, put an inner tube in, and then again use the CO2 canister to pump it back up. And if I've touched wood, I've never had to use one, but if you do have to use them, they basically just shove a load of CO2 into your tyre and it inflates really fast, so it's perfect for out on the trail. And that means that I don't have to carry a pump with me as well. So that there is everything I take out on a less than 2 hour ride. I'll shoot another video at some point in the future where I'll show you what I take out on longer rides, but this is everything that I need. The only probable addition that would be beneficial would be some kind of first aid kit. I should probably add that in there. Now I've shot this video, I'll probably end up needing it. But apart from that, that's everything I take out. I'd be interested to hear if you've got any questions, if you think something's missing from my pack, or if you'd just like some more information on the things I carry, then leave a comment below and let me know. And if you'd like to watch more MTB Fitness videos, click somewhere around here, and you can subscribe on one of them, and then go watch another video as well. Thanks so much for watching.